gonna do an update on this Cardi B and Nicki Minaj drama, okay? There were more than enough channels handling everything, okay? When I was sent a particular video, okay, that I'm not going to show here, we gonna talk about it. I felt like shots were being thrown at us YouTubers and podcasters, so I had to come on here and say something and speak for us, okay? Now, just in case you don't know, ever since Friday of last week, when Cardi B waited outside in the hallway for Nicki Minaj to be done with press, and when she was done, Cardi B was waiting in the hallway to throw a shoe and catch a lump, but nobody caught her bad ass. Take a look again at this damn video and see if you can see what I see. Do you see what I see? She has yet to show on Instagram. She's showing everything else, but that damn lump that's actively being drained right now at the doctor, okay? Because I told you, my mama had one of them when I was around like 13 years old. She got hit with a car door. You know, she was fighting with a boyfriend or some shit like that. I don't know the specifics, but she came home with the same lump, and it took about a week and a half to 2 weeks to go down, but the doctor had to actually drain the fluid because the fluid kept building up. Then her eyes shut, and I'm sure this is what Cardi B is going through right now, okay? That's why we ain't gonna see no pictures, but we'll see her post things like her Tom Ford lipstick that sold out after the drama. Congrats to Cardi on that. Now, but I don't think we should have had to see her bare ass to claim it, okay? But she's used to it. I mean, she's used to showing her bare ass for a coin, so if she like it, I love it. Now, there's a lot of people talking about Cardi B's energy per se, okay? Specifically, this crying in the car ass nigga here, okay? But hold that thought. I'ma roast his ass in a second. Cause everybody seems to think that they have a place in this beef. And I say this to say, because I grew up in a town where we fought, okay? We kept that same energy, okay? That's the type of bitch I am. Now, the only reason I'm making this video is because I wanted to address the shots that were being thrown, okay? By two niggas that remind me of folks we know that will be quick to instigate a fight, but when it comes down to a fight, they ain't really about that goddamn life, okay? Quick to talk shit about Nicki hiding behind security, but everybody knows that she's always traveled with damn security. But you always got them two friends that will egg another friend on, like Cardi friends, DJ Envy and Charlamagne egging her on to go after a bitch that she will never be able to get to because Nicki's money is damn long, okay? And I'm sorry, when you got friends that would proudly instigate some shit, but as soon as some shit goes down, they asses are able to go back to work, but you ain't. Them ain't your real damn friends, okay? Now, let's talk about these niggas here, all right? Let's talk about these two instigating ass niggas that claim they about that life, but they ain't about shit but cheating on women and taking shit from women. Let's just keep it real. I'm sure y'all came up in a town or in a city where if there was a fight or there was about to be a fight and then the fight occurred, everybody that watched the fight, okay, or that instigated the fight, and half the time these motherfuckers could talk their way out of a fight like Charlamagne here. Hold that thought, okay? I'ma get on his ass in a second. But there are those, they somehow muster the courage and insert themselves into a beef because a person that they may be rooting for, like Cardi B, to show her ass, because a lot of people live through the spirit of Cardi B because she does the shit that a lot of people wish that they could do. And so when Cardi B pops off on somebody, which is in her DNA, there's a lot of motherfuckers out here making videos talking mad shit about what they would have done, what they could have done, what should have happened, but we all know they really ain't about that life. Like Charlamagne here with them niggas he was talking shit about at the radio station showed up outside and this nigga took off running because of some shit he said about them. Watch this.
What's good, my G? Can I get a drop?
What's up with y'all?
I need a drop,
man.
I need a drop, son. I need a drop, baby. What's up? Come on. Let's get a drop.
Now, since Charlamagne and DJ Envy want to get on their radio show after Cardi B did some shit that they wish they could do, DJ Envy too talking about kids are off limits. Cardi B had every right to show her ass at any party at any time, especially when it comes to kids. But this same nigga here called the police on Star when Star threatened to R. Kelly his kids. But this is the same nigga here, DJ Envy and Charlamagne, the two radio guys, the same ones that got silent when Birdman showed up on their ass, and they didn't say the same shit that they said on the radio about Birdman. But you always got them two niggas, we went to school with them, whether they're females or males, that like to live through other bitches because they don't have the courage to do the shit that the real bitches doing, like Cardi and Nicki Minaj. Now, Charlamagne out here talking about don't act crazy around white people. There was probably so much cocaine in that party, and Cardi B had every right to keep the same energy that she raps about in her rap song and that she talks about on the internet at any given place at any time. But yet, this is the same nigga that changed up his energy when HBO was coming for his ass when them rape allegations surfaced, okay? But did Charlamagne keep that same energy? Nope. Now, I'm telling you, everybody know niggas like this. They live through other people because they got too much to lose because they really ain't about that damn life. People egging on this shit trying to justify that Cardi had every right to attack Nicki, and at the expense of attacking Nicki, a person that she knows she would never get close to because Nicki does roll with security pretty deep. But she do have those two talking ass friends that ain't about that life that will instigate a situation like this. But when this bitch leaves an event embarrassed by the whole world with a lump that she has yet to show yet on social media and her bare ass out to the public again, but she left that life alone, these two niggas here, DJ Envy and Charlamagne, get to go back to class while this bitch loses everything that she works for. But they telling Cardi, keep that same energy. I want to see Charlamagne keep that same energy when that little girl is done with her private investigation on that ass. A girl who he has yet to send his lawyers after, but he sent his lawyers after every YouTuber and podcaster and radio guy or girl when we decided to report on the story. But he didn't keep that same energy. But yeah, this is a nigga talking about keeping the same energy, but he ain't keep the same energy that he kept with me, that he kept with Star and every other person that he came after. But he ain't come after the person that was making the allegations talking about he raped her. Some shit he bragged about on the internet, but as soon as them white folks, the same white folks that he said that a lot of young people shouldn't be embarrassed to act a fool around, the same white folks that have been oppressing, okay, minorities for years to discriminate and use the shit that we do against us so that they can make a mockery of us. But this is the same nigga that has a platform telling young folk to keep the same energy that Cardi B kept, but this nigga won't even live by his own damn words. Yeah, these niggas may try to fight me and shit, but they'll never be able to beat me with words because this nigga is trapped in a radio station with security reading from a goddamn script. And the same shit that he said during that radio show, which I'm not going to play here, okay? I'm only speaking on behalf of the podcasters and the YouTubers that he took shots at, the same motherfuckers that brought him down to his knees and made him change that energy when his ass was about to lose every damn thing that he worked for because of some energy that he was spewing back in the day, spiking E and J and Sprite, so that he can get ass from girls that wouldn't even look twice at his hyperpigmentation face ass. But he didn't keep that same energy and send his lawyers after them girls, but he sent his lawyers after anybody that posted that damn story, giving commentary on some shit that he bragged about and had all this positive energy talking about, specifically rape culture, some shit that he knows very fucking well. But he didn't keep that same energy when them white folks at HBO took that motherfucking deal. Now, anybody that know me from Panama City, Florida, know the Tasha K that's sitting right here. I was the same bitch sitting on Kersey and the same bitch sitting up here in Cobb County right damn now. Since that nigga want to take shots at podcasters over a fight that he was living through because he will never have the dick or never have the balls to do what Cardi B and Nicki Minaj are doing right now because he's a bitch. Just simple, point blank, period. Now run tell that. Now I gotta go, okay? I'm done with this damn foolery. Now, for those of y'all that have stories, tips, and information on celebrities, please feel free to send me an email to unwindwithtasha shakay@gmail.com, or you could give me a call directly. My number and email is below in the comments, as well as in the description box, or you can visit my website, unwindwithtashakay.com. We need these here stories, okay? Especially the ones on damn niggas like Charlamagne, okay? So when the bitch come forward, the one in D.C. who claims it was a drink spike, allegedly he gave her E&J and Sprite with some other shit in it, the same shit he bragged about, call me, okay? I'll be glad to take that goddamn story. Now, let's see if he keep that same goddamn energy. If you want to advertise on my platform, please feel free to send me an email via TashaKBusiness@gmail.com, and somebody from my advertising team will get right back with you to discuss your advertising needs. Now, for those of y'all that have questions, okay, about expanding your wine tasting palette, I am personally partnered with the Tasting Room, okay, with a link that I'm going to provide below this video in the description box as well as in the comment section. Once you visit the link, okay, they're going to ask you 3 simple questions about what you like in your food, coffee, fruit, and from that, they're going to curate 6 different bottles of mini wines from all over the world, all for $9.95, okay? The Tasting Room, the link is below. For those of y'all that want merchandise, all right, pillows, shirts, now I gotta go, shit, the link is below to my Amazon store. I also have some wine accessories that I highly personally recommend offered on my Amazon store that is also below this video, okay? I'm not linking shit that I don't personally buy, all right? And for those of y'all that are wondering what I'm drinking, okay, I'm drinking something special today, okay? I'm trying to keep that same goddamn energy. Woo, this is a slow press. Cabernet, all right? And what they mean by slow press, this wine took 10 months to age in an oak barrel, okay? And when you taste this wine, it's very rich, earthy, and I love wine. I'm telling you, I love wine like this, especially a good goddamn Cabernet. This is my shit. This is my type of shit here. Just eases down slow. Since it was a slow process, okay, to make this wine. And in this wine, you taste some oak because it was aged in an oak barrel for almost a year. And you taste some dark fruits as well as robust and kind of velvety tannins, all right? And we got this wine all for $12 and some change. And of course, a link will be below this video so that you can purchase this slow press Cabernet Sauvignon, okay, for some grown folks on this channel, okay? The link is below. Thank you all so much for watching, all right? If you like this video, subscribe. You can also find me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat at Unwind with Tasha K. Please be sure to have your reminder set for Fuckery Fridays, okay? When we get it motherfucking started. Hit the wine glass. I will also put the link to the early bird of the Fuckery Friday below this video so you can go ahead, do what you got to do, put the kids to sleep, take them to their friend house since it's Friday, and we can get it here started, okay? I got some shit on 50 Cent. We go unwind. And a whole lot more other people, all right? 7 o'clock on Friday. And hell, if you didn't like this video, you can still subscribe anyway just so you can cuss my ass out. Not that I'ma really give a damn anyway. Now I gotta go. Bye.